Hi everyone, my name is Karishma, I'm from Team Nykaa, and today I'm here with Dr. Jayashree Sharad, a celebrity cosmetic dermatologist. So I'm going to be asking you a few questions today for our viewers. So my first question to you today is, what ingredient do you think that we should be, that anyone should be using in like a sunscreen or like a day cream or night cream?
So sunscreen depends on the skin type basically. What you should be looking at is a physical block. It should have titanium dioxide, zinc oxide, and then it should have something called Mexoryl, Ecampsule. These are really good, powerful ingredients which will protect you from UVA and UVB. So don't just look at the SPF, you have to look at PA++++ as well. So that's about the sunscreen. When it comes to a day cream, it should be a light moisturizer, something which is not too heavy, something which does not clog your pores and, you know, does not make your face look greasy. And so it could be squalene, it could be lactic acid, alpha hydroxy acids, mineral oil. Whereas a night cream can be a little thick and heavy. So cocoa butter, coconut oil, olive oil, shea butter, these are the ingredients that you look for in a night cream.
My second question to you is, what is an appropriate age for men and women to start using skincare products?
Why men and women? You know, the moment a child starts learning how to brush and do his own thing and bathe and wear his own clothes or her own clothes, that's the time you start skincare. They could use products which are meant for children. Could be a moisturizer, could be a sunscreen, and as simple as that, but that's the right age to start. So maybe 8, maybe 9, maybe 10.
What would you say would be an ideal like skin regime routine that women should use, like a working woman from 9 to 5?
I think the most important thing is a good cleanser. And so you cleanse your face once in the morning and cleanse your face once at bedtime. Make sure you remove your makeup at night, however tired you are. The sunscreen should never be forgotten. You know, even if it is raining or on a cloudy day, like, you know, your seasons, monsoons, you work indoors, you're traveling by a Mercedes, you still need that sunblock because, you know, UVA and UVB protection is extremely mandatory. UVA penetrates glass. So even if you're, you know, have your windshields on, you still have to use a sunscreen. So that's very important. You need to hydrate your skin. So just drinking water is not enough. So you need to use a moisturizer at least once in a day, even if you have oily skin. So there are water-based moisturizers available, so you can use them.
It's become very common that people are now using dermacosmetic brands, and a lot of us don't really know what dermacosmetic is. So can you provide us a bit of insight on it?
Dermacosmetic means it's basically a marriage between cosmetics and pharmaceutical products, medicine products. They are really thoroughly researched and a lot of laboratory work goes on to get a dermacosmetic product, and they actually penetrate the mid layer of the skin. So they really work well. Their concentration is also high. You know, whatever ingredient, if you compare it to a cosmetic product, the concentration of the ingredient is always higher in a dermacosmetic brand. And they're usually monitored by US FDA, whereas a cosmetic product, there are no guidelines, we don't know if there's enough research going on there. So that's the advantage of a dermacosmetic, and it's nice to use. It's a, you know, after all, like a cosmetic brand, but at the same time, it's medicinal as well.
Would you recommend that users now move to dermacosmetic brands or stick to their regular brands?
All the time, I tell them to use dermacosmetic brands. I mean, because you have to use something that works and works really well, you know? So I would say dermacosmetics.
Do you think it's important to follow a particular skincare regime to deal with problems like acne and dullness and dryness and pigmentation?
Absolutely. I mean, your skincare will depend on the type of skin you have and the problem skin that you have. So if you have oily skin and acne, then there's a particular routine. If you have pigmentation, then you know your sunscreen is important. You make sure you don't stress too much, don't wear perfumes on the skin. All this will increase pigmentation. Go to a dermatologist, find out why you have the pigmentation, and then follow that particular routine. Use vitamin C, vitamin A, these kind of ingredients in your products. If you have acne, then make sure you don't use thick creams on the face, which will occlude your pores and, you know, give you more whiteheads and blackheads. So it's very important to use the right kind of skincare product. And today in the market, there are so many that one tends to get confused. So I would always suggest the first consult with a dermatologist is really important. Do that once and then you don't need to see us again.
And finally, since you're a specialist in lasers as well, I wanted to know, do you think lasers can work in ways in which skin products cannot?
No, see, they're two completely different things, you know. I mean, skin products, skincare, whatever dermaceuticals that you use, they have to be done lifelong. Skin is a lifetime maintenance. We're always aging. We're always, exposed to pollution, stress, this, that, the other. You can't keep doing lasers on your face all the time. I mean, you know, they will at some point of time make your skin sensitive. And there's lasers, not the one-stop solution. I mean, if you have acne, you have to do skincare and medication. No laser is going to help you. You know, maybe for hair removal or for pigmentation or some kind of nevus that you have on the face or you have scars on the face, that's where the role of a laser comes in. So they're completely two different things, and you know, your dermocosmetics will always play a big role in your skincare.
Thank you, doctor, for answering all our questions. I'm sure this is going to be very informative for all our customers out there.
My pleasure. Thank you, Team Nykaa, for having me here.
Thank you guys for watching our video with Dr. Jayashree Sharad. If you have any questions, please feel free to post them below and we will get back to you. Hope to see you soon. Bye.